glad to welcome today Jean-Marie Monietti, CEO of CoinShares, and Pascal Gauthier, CEO of Ledger. Pascal and Jean-Marie have worked together to create Komainu, the first regulated digital asset custody built for institutions. They have created this joint venture along with Nomura, the Japanese investment bank. Before going to our discussion on digital assets custody and their joint venture, I would like to give a brief introduction on both Pascal and Jean-Marie. Pascal, as it was mentioned, is the CEO of Ledger. Pascal started his career at Quelqu'u, for those who remember, the French price comparator acquired by Yahoo in 2004. Pascal subsequently joined Criteo, the French advisory platform, marketing advisory platform, for which he was the CEO and for which he took an active part in the IPO on the Nasdaq in 2013. And following, Pascal became an investor in Ledger, its board member, and in 2017, its CEO. Jean-Marie started as a quantitative energy trader before joining Global Advisors Group, a British investment house. Jean-Marie started at Global Advisors Group as a quantitative trader also. He became subsequently the CEO of Global Advisors Group Jersey Limited and a director of Global Advisors Group. Jean-Marie created CoinShares in 2017, and CoinShares now managed more than 1 billion euros in assets. And Jean-Marie, you are now the CEO of the joint venture Komainu, created along, as I mentioned, with Ledger and Nomura Bank. So now, as I have you today on board, my first question would be both of you, as entrepreneur and creator of and founder of the joint venture Komainu, what's your vision and ambition with Komainu? So Jean-Marie, maybe if you can start, and after we'll ask Pascal to take over.
So, I'm going to try to stay succinct because it can be a three-hour discussion, but as per the previous discussion before we started this panel, but digital asset and derived tokenization is changing the way we produce and consume financial service in a wider definition. This is a deep change, which is affecting every layer of the financial services as we know them. For instance, when you think about the European financial backbone like Euroclear, that was created in 1973 and didn't really change since then. There's like some evolution internally, but the piping of the infrastructure didn't really change. And that's why we created Komainu as an enabler of this evolution. It's not to be confused with a revolution, it's really an evolution where Komainu is acting as an interface between the analog traditional world and the digital world.
Thank you, Jean-Marie. Pascal, I don't know if you want to add a word on your vision on the market and ambition also for you as Ledger, with already well established crypto assets, digital custody.
I'm just talking to Pascal on WhatsApp. He can't connect. He's saying he can't connect to the platform.
Okay, so I guess we work with the techniques. I guess let's move on. I think Jean-Marie. So as far as you are alone, so let's move on. So thank you for your answer. We mentioned that Komainu is the first regulated digital custody. It's regulated now out of Jersey as a traditional custody. What do you think is missing for now as a real and efficient digital asset custody regulation, to come? Because for now there is no regulation available.
Okay, so The first problem of regulation is like regulation is a bit of a piecemeal game, I would say, at a global scale, which has always been the case, but it's even more the case with digital assets. But even in Europe, where you can see different initiatives, you know, whether it's in front of AMF, in Italy with Consol, or in Germany with BaFin, you can see different kind of like stream, and some people going more for banking regulation type, and some other going for this kind of VASP regime. And then on top of that, the European Commission is doing their own research and publish a paper, I think, on Monday night, explaining which directions they were looking at writing law about that specific topic to be implemented by central bank or whoever would be responsible for that in their mind. Now, you know, my biggest concern right now when I look at the way regulation is evolving is like to see how the regulation is trying to create digital asset almost as a standalone regulation, instead of trying to see how digital assets can fit in the existing model. We are trying, you know, to some extent, like the blockchain and DLT technology is more like a change in the way you consume the securities product, whether they are old securities product or new securities product. And at that point, you know, creating a complete VASP regime where you can, you know, issue quasi securities, which are not called securities for more semantic reason than anything else, as a VASP operator with very little regulation is not satisfactory. And I don't think it's satisfactory, especially for institutions who are looking at be feeling reinsured and feeling safe with this kind of new framework, which they don't really embrace yet. Some of them are looking at embracing it and are trying to learn how to do it, but the kind of absence of clear framework and more of this kind of, I would say, superficial one, let's call it a VASP, and that's going to be good for it, is not giving enough confidence for institutions to say, okay, we can go for it. But plenty of institutions are looking at it very closely now, so we hope to see it evolving in the future.
Thank you for your answer. Not to maybe to come back a minute on Komeinu. So we mentioned that this is a joint venture between CoinShares, Ledger, and Nomura. Can you tell us more on what each of the partners in this joint venture is bringing to Komeinu, and what makes, thanks to this, Komeinu different to other digital asset custodians already available on the market?
Sure. So Komeinu is unique by its founding member. It's a pretty much unique value position where at the beginning of the story, you get CoinShares, an asset manager, an investment house, having a real issue to do custody. And like looking at its own problem, we are at the peak of 2017 and our assets are peaking around 1.5 billion. And, you know, as you can imagine, regulators start to call because we're regulated for at that point already 10 years in Jersey. Regulators start to call saying, where is the client money? Our clients start to call, say, how do you prove us the money exists or the coins exist? Our listed product on NASDAQ in Sweden, NASDAQ start to inquire about, okay, well, there's probably a risk here. Can you demonstrate the asset exists? So plenty of questions around, and auditors asking the same question as well. Say, we have to sign your audit at the end of the year. It's a 1.5 billion liability. Does it exist? How do we know it exists? At that point, we have plenty of custody solution. You know, there was a lack of Zappo in the market. There was a lack of Hitbit, Gemini, who were already there. So we were kind of like having a mix of uses with all these guys. But nothing was done properly to satisfy, I would say, a financial service need because it was not built as a financial service. So with that problem in mind, was questions like, what do we need to build a proper financial service around custody? And what do we need at that point is three things, like trust, not as a regulation, but trust as a word, transparency, and technology. The trust is a very interesting one because in our consumerism society, we tend to believe that trust is something you can buy from people with a check. Unfortunately, it is a notion you earn, and you don't earn it because you're a good person. You earn it because the effect of time makes its office, and you can just start benefiting of this de facto trust you earn through the years. So the only way we can find this trust component is to find a partner for us which is bringing years and years of existence and I've been through many generation of customers and many economic life cycle. So off we go looking for these partners, and you know, in this discussion, Nomura, for various reasons, we can be organic ones and also external ones, appears to be the perfect partner in these stories. Plus the Japanese kind of heritage is very interesting for us around the notion of trust and the notion of fiduciary duty, but also an implicit wink, I would say, to Satoshi Nakamoto, which has some kind of Japanese influence. So that was Nomura joining and bringing this trust element. And then at that point, with Konchi and Nomura, and like, you know, the discussion, like, okay, well, Jean-Marie, very nice to tell us we're going to custody, but how do we make it happen now? We don't know anything about it, so what do we do? So at that point, we have two options, like, either we raise money, or we just invest money and build our own team and build our own tech, or we just find the best in-class cybersecurity company, one of the European champions, called Ledger, to join the party. So building it yourself is not satisfactory because effectively you're just creating another black box, and the market wants transparency. So black box was not an option. So what we did is like, you know, convince Ledger of that this idea was a great idea, and you know, they welcome our idea and embrace the project, and Pascal becomes the internal champion of this project to make sure Ledger was working with us in this joint venture. And that's how it was born. So you end up having trust, transparency, and technology in one place. And that was the kind of three pillars to build Komainu. Then Komainu is also unique because Komainu is building a financial service institution powered by technology, not a technology company to replace financial institution. I think it's a key difference and nuance in the way that we are not competing with people like Cassie East or Société Générale Security Services or with Pictet. We are enabling them to enter the digital asset world, and we are enabling them to participate in this evolution of the way we consume financial services. And finally, I would say Komainu is unique by the quality of its human capital. The expertise we have on board is just first in class, and our client quickly realized that after 5 minutes with us, they speak a complete, we all speak the same language and we understand completely their problematic, and they feel it's refreshing to finally in digital asset, having the capacity to speak with people who are sharing the same, I would say, denominated factors.
Thank you, Jean-Marie. So I think we have Pascal now on board also. So thank you, Pascal, for joining.
Pleasure. Sorry that I'm late. I had the wrong Zoom link, so it's all good now.
No problem. Well, okay. So, as you may know, so we have started the discussion with Jean-Marie. We have spoken about the ambition, the vision of Komainu, the fact the entity is regulated also. Now I have a question for you, as you are here. How does Komainu complete your services offering, and how does it reinforce yourself as Ledger and as a crypto asset custodian in the industry?
Sure. So first, thank you for having me. Sorry again that I'm late. I think it's clear first to state that Ledger is a technology company. So we're not a custodian per se, but we power custodians with technology, and we power different players in the industry with technology. If you need to secure private keys, and if you want to make them easy to use and have very strong security and governance rules, you would use typically Ledger Vault and Ledger technology in general. So that's what we do. When we build the project with Jean-Marie and Nomura, you know, it was under this idea that if you look at traditional assets and custodianship for traditional assets, it's a fairly concentrated business, and it felt quite natural that for critical digital assets, whether it's Bitcoin, security tokens, and all the tokenized economy that is unfolding in front of our eyes, it will probably be the case that you will have the same level of concentration. And so for Ledger, it was a sort of strategic question of whether we wanted a large piece of that business. And if you think about the pure custody business, I think that if you fast forward in 10 years and you end up with sort of, you know, five dominant players and, you know, everyone ranging from 10 to, you know, 15, 20% market share, the question is, how do you get involved in one early enough? So this is the bet that we've made with Komainu, and this is sort of what we see happening right now. But the ledger technology powers custodians, powers many other type of players, not just custodians. And so, you know, ledger, when we think about what we do, we think about technology and empowering businesses with security and ease of use, I guess, to manage their crypto assets, whatever they may be.
Thank you. Maybe now to come back more on regulated aspects. So you are regulated in Jersey with Komainu. I know the solution is scaling up in Europe, America, in Asia. Do your clients or institutional clients consider that the fact that you are regulated as an advantage compared to other competitors?
So I think our clients, our institutional clients are not taking that as an advantage. It takes that as a prerequisite to talk to a custodian. It's like the problem in the industry right now is the industry has used the notion of trust to define the notion of custody. And trust and custody are really two different elements. In the trust law, you have like all the concept of trustee, settler, and all this kind of lovely acronym, which effectively are transferring the, not the ownership, but transferring the control of your asset to someone else. In a custody model, where you have a custodian or depository, it's a very, very different model. So we are custodian, we're regulated as a custodian and a depository, which is a very departure from what we see in the US, people acting as trustee to operate a safekeeping function. So to go back to your question, our clients are expecting us to be regulated this way, and they don't take it as even an advantage. It's like it's just a prerequisite for them to start the discussion.
Thank you. And last question for both of you, as we are today in Luxembourg. How do you see Luxembourg positioning itself on the crypto assets market overall, and also on the digital assets custody business? And yourself, do you see opportunities for you and for Komainu going forward, potentially to come to Luxembourg? Because I know that Germany, for instance, and you may have discussions in France, Germany, or in any other countries, is setting up right now a specific regulation for digital asset custody.
So when it comes to Luxembourg, I think I get an answer in 2-4. Luxembourg has been, I would say, at the avant-garde for a while now, attributing licenses, especially around payment service provider, to company like Bitstamp or Bitflyer very, very early on. But there is a long tradition in Luxembourg where you get company like Rakuten and others, international company, having their hub in Luxembourg for the payment service provider. So there is a tradition around technology and payments in Luxembourg. That's something we are following very closely at Komainu, because Komainu has a global ambition. So we're looking out to expand Komainu worldwide, and continental Europe is definitely something we're looking at with a very solid business case. There is, as I mentioned before in the discussion, different, I would say, flavor of regulation across Europe as we speak, between a very banking regulation in Germany and a very BaFin regulation type in Italy or France. So it's all about finding the, and Ireland will get a very MiFID kind of reading of this problematic. So it's kind of finding the right balance, and we have definitely Luxembourg on the map of our option. Now, like I would say, the caveat for digital asset player when it comes to Luxembourg, if I have to find a caveat, is like Luxembourg, you know, most of, I would say 90% of the digital asset players are powered by Amazon or Azure, because everything is cloud hosted. It's not really the case for custody businesses, it's a bit different, but like I'll talk about the digital asset industry in general. And the regulatory framework in Luxembourg requires, unless you get a special derogation, to have your asset hosted in Luxembourg. And unfortunately, there is no data center from the top provider in Luxembourg to support that. So that's kind of the kind of the, I would say, the break on the nice trajectory, which could be, I would say, putting some digital asset company away from Luxembourg in the short term. But it's just a problem to resolve, and I'm sure there is some derogation you can work around with the regulator in this case.
Thank you. So thank you, both of you, for the time, because I think we are running out of time now. So thank you for taking the time this morning. Sorry, Pascal, for the few technical issues. Okay. And thank you, and hope to meet you personally again when the COVID-19 crisis will pass in Luxembourg.
Perfect. Thank you very much for organizing.